So, very good afternoon, all the students. Now, let us continue with the topic that is protection of metals. In the last lecture, what we saw is what is cathodic protection, and now let us continue with the topic that is anodic protection. Now, anodic protection, it's very similar to that of cathodic protection, but here the metal is forced to behave as anode. Instead of cathode, it is forced to behave as anode. Now, how it behaves as anode is we can just apply a external potential to the metal and make the metal show. I means if you apply the potential in the passive range, the metal stops right reacting to the environment. Now, how I can explain is you can just read the slide. The first point you can see the metal like iron, steel, stainless steel, aluminium, chromium, etc. They show passivity when a certain range of potential is applied on them. Now, if you see the diagram on the shown on the right side, right, any metal you take, any metal, if a potential is applied to that metal and corrosion rate is studied, now as you can see, a metal initially it shows a constant increase in the corrosion rate as the potential is increasing, right? But when it reaches to a particular potential, right, when it reaches to a particular potential, the corrosion rate starts decreasing. The corrosion rate starts decreasing, and at this point, the corrosion rate becomes almost constant, if you see, right? And this continues as an even if it is, the potential is increased up to certain point. Now, this point to this point, right, this is called as passive range, right? And after that, what happens? If further increase in the potential, it increases the again corrosion rate. Now, every metal will have this passive range. Understand? So, if you apply that particular potential, right, this particular potential to that metal, it will stop, right, reacting to the environment. Right? External environment doesn't affect its nature, or it doesn't, the corrosion doesn't start, right? Or it can be protected for longer time. And if you see the second point, every metal and alloy has a characteristic passivity range voltage, but all the metals do not have the range wide enough to employ the anodic protection technique for corrosion control. What does that mean? Not all metal will show this kind of behavior because this range has to be big, right? Most of the metals, they show a very narrow range where the potential, right, maintaining that particular potential becomes difficult. So some metals, luckily, what is mentioned here is iron, steel, stainless steel, aluminium, chromium. These are the metals which shows passivity range, a very good passivity range, and these metal can be protected by applying an external voltage or external potential, and to that which is equal to that of passivity range. Understand? So point number three, the metal becomes non-reactive or corrosion resistant when the voltage applied on the metal corresponds to the passivity range. Understand? So the whole process is based on all these three points, three important points. Now let us move to the what actually the method is, right? Now, principle of this anodic protection is a metal or alloy having wider range of passivity voltage, it is made anodic, and the voltage in the passivity range is applied over it to control the corrosion even by the strong corroding media. What does that indicate? The metal, right? If you see this diagram itself, this is very good presentation, right? Any metal, if this potential is applied, whatever means whatever passive range is there, if that is applied, then the likely chances that it will not react to the medium which is present, or it will not react to the environment or any conditions. For example, if you supply a passive voltage of iron to iron tank, then it is going to get protected even if you keep acid or base or whatever in that iron tank. So only drawback of this method is you have to maintain that potential. That is the only thing, right? If you are not able to maintain this potential, is going to cause a severe problems again, or the rate of the corrosion may increase very drastically if you don't maintain the temperature. Now, what is the construction and working? Now, A very simple water tank. I will just read out these points. The metallic installation like reactor, water tank, industrial water coolers, industrial condenser side is made anodic by using reference electrode and auxiliary electrode. Now, as shown in the diagram, I will show that diagram. Now, if you observe this diagram, this is the diagram which shows the anodic protection. Now, here you see this is the iron tank. Number one given is here, iron tank which contains a very strong corrodant, and there are three electrodes here. This point number two is the tank is made of anode. It is made as anode. Now this is connected to an electrode, right? This electrode is not dipped in the solution. Understand? So this is only connected to the tank, which has to be protected. Now there are two different electrodes, right? Again, the third one is reference electrode. Here the reference electrode used is platinum, and the fourth one is the auxiliary electrode, that is graphite electrode. Now there are three electrodes. One is connected to tank, and the different two electrodes, they are dipped in the solution. Now this is called as potentiostat. If you see the point number five, potentiostat, what is the role of this potentiostat? It maintains the potential, right? It maintains the potential of this tank, right? It will maintain at the particular, that is passive voltage. A voltmeter is applied, if you see point number six, and ammeter, right? Voltmeter and ammeter will tell you what is the voltage and what is the current, what are the things, what were corrosion current, especially corrosion current, right? So these are the, this is what is a representation of the or construction of the protection. Now this particular is explained by taking an example of a iron tank, right? Iron tank which contains of strong corrodant electrolyte. Understand? Now what are the things which, right, which can which metal will get protected by using this? What is only the metal which shows passivity range. You remember that. If the metal is not showing a large enough passive range, it is not going to, this method is not going to work for it. We need to use some different method for that one. Now, coming to the application part of this, right? You can see here, now chemical reactors or continuous chemical reactions were going on that can be protected. You know what is chemical reactions are, they involve a very huge corrosive chemicals or corrosive environment, then there it can be protected. Complex metallic installations underground, under sea water can be protected, and industrial water coolers, then industrial metal condensers, pipelines for carrying corrosive liquid fuels, all this one can be protected by using this particular method. Advantages: it has a low operating cost, applicable to highly corrosive medium. Even if corrosion medium is very very strong, there also it will be applicable. It is reliable, it protects complex structures, right? It feasible of all method, it is feasibility of method can be predicted in laboratory. Now we can study in on small scale what is the feasibility of particular protection of particular metal, and the same thing can be extrapolated on larger scale. Now protection current gives an idea about the corrosion rate. Now corrosion rate also can be studied by using this process. Now some limitations are there. As I told you that if the first limitation is if the system goes out of control, right, then the corrosion rate is very high. So what does it mean? The system goes out of control means if you don't maintain that exact passive range, it is not going to respond. Or if it fails to maintain either the corrosion, the passive range, the potential increases or decreases, right, then this they're going to be a very huge problem. The corrosion rate will drastically increase rather than decreasing. Now high starting current required, now potential is required, as you know. Then high installation cost. Initial installation requires a huge cost, it involves huge cost. Applicable to only those metal which shows active and passive behavior. All the metals doesn't show a large passive range, therefore it is not suitable for each and every metal. Some different methods can be applied for the other metals or the metal which doesn't show the passive range. Now there may be a question, how do you, right, distinguish between the cathodic protection and anodic protection. Now these are some of the points which you can just see on the screen and just read it out. I'm not going to go in detail of this. This is very simple. I just kept it on the screen. You can just pause this one and you can just read it out. So what we learned in this one is, this lecture is, what is anodic protection, which type of metal it shows anodic protection, what are the conditions which is necessary for doing the anodic protection, and which type of metal can be protected, its construction, working, the diagram, the application, advantages and limitations, right? So this is another important point apart from the cathodic protection. So we'll continue with the lecture. I just request all the students to go through all my lectures on the daily basis, so that you will be in touch with the next whatever I upload, right? So thank you very much.